I unlock the casket of memory and draw back the warders of the brain, and there this scene of my infant wandering still lives unfaded, or with fresher dyes. A new sense comes upon me, as in a dream. A richer perfume, brighter colors start out, my eyes dazzle, my heart heaves with its new load of bliss, and I am a child again. My sensations are all glossy, spruce, voluptuous and fine. They wear a candied coat and are in holiday trim. I see the beds of larkspur with purple eyes, tall holy oaks, red and yellow, the broad sunflowers, caked in gold, with bees buzzing round them, wildernesses of pinks and hot glowing peonies. Poppies run to seed, the sugared lily, and faint mignonette, all ranged in order, and as thick as they can grow, the box tree borders, the gravel walks, the painted alcove, the confectionery, the clotted cream. I think I see them now with sparkling looks, or have they vanished while I have been writing this description of them? No matter. They will return again when I least think of them. All that I have observed since of flowers and plants and grass plots and of suburb delights seems, to me, borrowed from that first garden of my innocence, to be slips and scions stolen from that bed of memory. If I have pleasure in a flower garden, I have it in a kitchen garden, too, and for the same reason. If I see a row of cabbage plants or of peas or beans coming up, I immediately think of those which I used to so carefully water of an evening at Wem, when my day's tasks were done, and of the pain with which I saw them droop and hang down their leaves in the morning sun.